Hi everyone, I hope you are staying at home, staying safe and following all the norms of the lockdown. I think, you know, last few days during this lockdown gave us a lot of time to think on a lot of things we were working on and give them a better shape. So as you know, Puneet Goods, a crafted fine goods, has always been at the helm of working with Indian craftsmen and karigars and bringing in contemporary products using oldish techniques, be it the meenakari, be it the metal craftsmanship, be it hand embroideries, be it exquisite handwork, be it you know, different interesting metal crafts. So it's always been a beautiful journey. So taking this journey forward today, we are happy to announce a new line of products by Puneet Gupta Crafted Fine Goods, which is labeled under Royal Heirlooms. So Royal Heirlooms by Puneet Gupta Crafted Fine Goods is a little small journey by us with the different royal families of India and bringing forward some products which are created by the royals for you. So essentially the concept is we'll get these products for you so you can simply shop from the royals and you can shop like royals and you can live like royals. Yes, exactly, you heard me right. Isn't that interesting? So, you know, and it's not just about products actually. You know, we want to touch base and kind of work with thousands of craftsmen across the country and bring them, you know, give them sustainable livelihood over the next few months since the time is so challenging right now. So, as a conversation starter for this entire project, we would like to talk to someone who is championing for a cause, a princess who's really stood and helm a cause which is very nice. So I'm going to be talking to Princess Richa Rajalakshmi of Danta. She has been working relentlessly with a lot of NGOs, especially working towards the greater good of those who are hearing impaired and giving them a better lifestyle. So let's see if Richa is here and let's try and connect with her and let's hear from her. How is she living her life? Let's actually hear from a royal. Hi, Richa.
Hi, Puneet. How are you? I hope you're safe.
How are you?
I'm good. Great. Thank you for this lovely invitation that you have given me and the chance to, you know, speak on this platform. Thank you so much for that.
No, it's our pleasure. Thank you for taking out time and, you know, speaking to us and the viewers here. So, Richard, where are you, you know, where are we talking to you? Like, where are you from right now? Where are you exactly?
At my farm right now. I stay in a place known as Danta, which I belong from. It's in North Gujarat. And I'm just lucky that in this lockdown, I'm at my farm. I couldn't have been, I think, you know, more luckier than that, seeing the situation, how people are really, you know, stuck in these hard times. So I'm just grateful to where I'm actually staying, you know. So
how are you spending your time during this quarantine? What do you do?
So I have started my brand Chitranjani a year back, and to be very frank, I didn't you know, there needed to be a cause and a story connected. So during this quarantine time and this, you know, hard time, when I realized that the karigars need work, the NGOs need our help, that is when I decided that, you know, my brand will be about shop for cause. My real sister is also hearing impaired, and she was since birth. She's had this difficulty in her life, and so this cause is very, very actually close to my heart. You know, it's something that I'm not just doing it. You know, it's something very close.
So, which NGOs are you currently working with, and how does this kind of help these NGOs? What do they do?
I started working with this NGO, which is in Palampur, which is 40 kilometers away from where I stay. It's also in Gujarat. And I will also be working with an NGO in Jaipur very soon, because I want to connect with the kids at the NGO and with my karigars together, because, you know, in any way if I can help them in future to even get any kind of employment, it will be great. It will be something that I would love to do.
Great. So is your life changed before, like, during quarantine, during this lockdown? Or you're leading the same life as it was earlier? How is it like?
you know, to be frank, my life has not at all changed. It has been the same because I'm very, very grateful and I'm extremely lucky. And I'm grateful to God that we all stay at this, farm, and my entire domestic help also stays with us, where people are having so much of an issue with. And and we've had a domestic help which are 20 years and plus old. We're like really old ones out here. And we have 6 to 7 families staying with us. So it's been difficult because, of course, we're not getting our necessities also. It's not that we, the food supplies have been a little difficult. And we are also, we are 40 of us staying together. We're like all of
Oh,
us counting together
that's a
are
big
40. Yeah, it's a big number. So it has been a little difficult when it comes to actually food supply. Otherwise, we are all quite comfortable. My domestic help is happy, and so are we. So,
Exactly.
yes.
So, tell me something, like, how has your childhood been like? Like, I'm assuming, was it a little different from a regular childhood of a regular child being born in a family?
Yeah, not really different. I would not say that. But yes, there were little rules and regulations that we had, and we had our timings, and my mother used to be very, very strict, especially during the night times. After we had a night shower, we were not allowed to even step out from our bed. We couldn't even put our feet on the floor. That was just a rule. That was my mother's rule. And yeah, so every time I wanted to go to my uncle's room, we all used to stay in a joint family before as a child. I grew up in where my grandmother stays. She stays in the palace, so we all grew up together there. And so I had to call up my uncle and tell him that please come up because my mother's not allowing me to even come down because I'm not allowed to step. So he used to literally climb up all those stairs and come and bring me down. So yeah, but otherwise it was all very, very normal. I used to love coming to the farm and playing with the kids. I love growing up with them. There was so much to explore. We used to explore so much. We used to go out walking in the jungle. We used to be, going out for night drives. So it used to be a lot of fun.
And is there were your bedtime stories different? As a kid, were they inspired by, the ancestral stories, or was it, how was it?
So my bedtime stories, I have to tell you, Vineet, it's very funny. It was a reverse role. It was me telling bedtime stories. I never heard bedtime stories. So when we used to be staying, in a joint family, so very fondly I call him B Dada. That's my father's elder brother, Bade Dada. The Dada means father. And he used to, every afternoon, I used to be told to come to him and tell him the story of three pigs and the wolf. And it was on repeat. Every day that story had to be told to him. And he used to be fast asleep in the middle of the story. And he used to, and I used to be just sitting there, gazing. And I used to be like, really, he's like fast asleep. So it was a reverse role. Then me listening to stories, I had to tell him a story. So yeah, but that used to be lots of fun. But I don't know how he heard me saying it on repeat mode. I don't know how he did it.
That's fine. I mean, that's sweet actually. So, are there any anecdotes from your childhood which could have only been possible, if you were born in a royal family, something which is very symbolic of your culture, or something which is very symbolic of your entire family?
Yes. Yeah, the biggest advantage, Puneet, that we, of course, to be born in this family and the privilege that I have is that we have this family temple, which is in Ambaji, which is 20 kilometers away. It's very, 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 very famous in Gujarat and it's known in all over India. And it's our Kuldevi and a personal puja to my forefathers and even to my grandfather till the time he was living. And we are very, very lucky and privileged that we do the Navratri. My Bade Dada and my first cousin brother and my fa and the entire family, they of course head of the family, so they start the puja and the havan. And so we're very privileged to go as a family and do that because there is this, the temple is crowded. It's huge amount of crowd which surrounds the temple because everybody wants to come and do you know, Mata Ji goddesses darshan during Navratri. And so, you know, that is the time when I really feel lucky, you know, that once a year, that feeling that I feel so, so lucky to be in such a huge
place,
you know,
and with so many devotees, you get to offer your prayers.
Offer to offer my prayers, and we get the temple to ourselves for some hours, and it's just a lovely, it's a beautiful feeling to be, you know, a part
of
something.
Reminds me of that scene from Bahubali, wherein, you know, the royal family is allowed to kind of do the worship and
It's something that I can't express it in words. You know, I would love for you to come and, you know, be a part of it, of it with us someday. But it's an overwhelming feeling to be in that temple, which, you know, people are literally pushing to get her blessings, and, you know, we just walk in.
So, you know, as royal families, we've all heard and known and seen, you know, you have wildlife, you've got vintage cars, you've got exquisite palaces, you've got heirloom textiles. So which part of that entire circle are you excited about or you like?
I really like the wildlife because we've been surrounded with, we used to be surrounded with a lot of wildlife. Obviously, civilization has taken over.
Okay.
But,
I
used to see a lot of panthers, when I was small. Yeah, a lot of them. It used to be, there used to be a time when I just shifted to my farm and we had all shifted. And, there used to be around 3:30 in the night, because that time we were the only area which had water. You know, in this particular place which had water. So they used to come around 3:30 in the night to drink water.
Okay.
And that's when we used to see an entire panther family just sitting and chilling and, you know, drinking water. So yeah, that has been a lot of wildlife memories.
So how is your bond with your sister? Like, how do the two of you spend time, and what inspired you to, you know, follow her?
Of course, I'm very, very close to her. All sisters are very close to each other. But my childhood had not been with her. We were not together when we were small.
Okay.
We weren't together. She was at my nani's place because of education. So she stayed there. And by the time she came back and shifted permanently with my parents, I was sent to Mayo College where I studied. I was there for 9 years.
Okay.
And we have a gap of, you know, 6 years also. So by the time she came back and, you know, I went away. So it's been in my early 20s and I really started spending time with her. Because I used to only come for holidays. And so did she, you know, she also came just for holidays. So that's when we really bonded. And that is when I really started understanding that, you know, even someone who cannot show has so much to tell. There's so much that they want to say, they need, and something that is needed is the support. You know, they don't want to be referred with that sympathy act. I'm so sorry you have this problem. They don't want to hear that. And that's what I learned from my sister, because she always told me that I don't want to, you know, please don't give me this sorry act, you know. I don't want this sympathy act, because I feel there's nothing missing in me. So why do people look at me like that? And which I also feel we should, you know, we all should change our perspective towards. Why should we all look at the special kids that there's something missing in them? You know, that's not really, I feel that's not really supporting them in a way.
So
that's when, so that's when actually I decided that, you know, whenever I have my brand, I will be helping these kids to actually just, my cause is basically to bring confidence in them, to get there out in the world and say that, listen, even if I can't hear, it's okay, I can do my bit. You know, there's no big deal. So it's more of that than actually.
And I think people like you who have voice in the society, it makes a lot more difference for people like you to stand up. Patronize a cause and influence a lot more, you know, the younger generation around us, and make them understand the sensitivity of the issue also is what I think.
Sensitivity also of the issue, Puneet, and also, you know, that the support is needed just to harbor that little necessary confidence. I'm not saying that you have to be overly confident about everything. You know, but it's just that necessary confidence that it's okay, you know, and also about having patience and not cribbing. We as people crib about little things in our life. You know, that ye nahi hua, wo nahi hua, you know, this is not happening. And not realizing that, you know, this I learned from my real sister. My sister, it's a simple thing. She can't hear music, you know. But in our daily life, it doesn't occur that even listening to music is a privilege.
Yeah.
You know, because...
The life and smallest things of life, that when you see people around you is when it kind of pinches you.
You know, I feel grateful every day of my life that I can go out with my friends, I can go out partying, I can listen to music, I can do my own work. It's just a small things, but it's in a very big way when you really look at it that way. So I just want to, you know, tell people to be just grateful in whatever they have, because, you know, you never know what the other person is really.
Even during this lockdown, I think it was a lot of eye-opening for a lot of people to understand that, learn to love simplest things of life, like even, you know, your home, your family members, the kind of life God has gifted us. I think we should all be thankful.
I totally agree, and it was so much of self-realization that everyone went through, and it's amazing because now everybody is coming out to be more human. You know, they were not stuck in that that life cycle of just doing that 9-to-5 job and okay, I need to do this, and I know everything was so materialistic. Things have, you know, people have changed, I would say, with their thinking in this lockdown. So,
I did some Insta digging on some of your pictures. So I'm going to pull up one or two pictures and would want to know when was this moment and, you know, like more about you. So the first one... on the screen.
Okay, so this picture is this is very funny. This has been taken in my best friend's house, Gohar Sardana, and that is her love of her life, Muffin, her dog, and he's the most pampered human. I don't even know if to call him also a dog, because he's like a human being, literally like a human being. So he's the most pampered human being, I think, on this planet Earth. And I was there in February for another best friend's wedding, Raj Kanwar's. So I was attending his wedding, actually. So that's a picture taken there.
And what about the next one?
Oh, this is my nani side of the family, where my mother is from. She's from
Oil. It looks like royal wedding to us.
This is Oil. She's from Oil. And that's my favoritest person getting married. That's my brother, who's right behind me, my first cousin. He's been a favorite since childhood. It's been like he was my guru and I'm his chela, like literally. Ooh, like that.
How sweet.
I used to be stuck behind him, Puneet. I used to like literally get stuck, like at times I think he got irritated also with me. I was like, why is this girl speaking to me? So I used to be stuck to him, and we've got too many memories. We are best friends to each other. There's nothing that he doesn't know about my life, and vice versa. And I have grown up playing only with G.I. Joes and He-Man during because I used to only play with him. So his thing was, if you want to play with me, then you play with G.I. Joe and He-Man. And when my turn used to come, then okay, now it's my turn, let's play with Barbie dolls. So he used to be like, no, my G.I. Joes are more important. So then I never grew up playing with Barbie dolls, because, you know, it was war of G.I. Joes and He-Man. But I've got some great memories with him. He's very, very close to me. He's extremely close to me.
No, that's great. So I think there should be someone like a guiding force in your life always.
And the little girl who's there is the star of the family. We are extremely fond of her. She's too funny. So and that's actually my nani side. My nani side of my real mama and my mommy and my sister, my first cousin sister.
So that does make a royal picture then. I mean,
yes. Okay. That's okay. It.
And what about this little this picture?
That, oh God, this is me, and this is apparently, this is when I had just, this is what my mother says, that I just had a hair wash basically, and I had just come out of a bath. And this was the stage where I was made to sleep purposely every day. After every 1 2 hours, my first cousin brother and sister used to come up because they wanted to play with my real sister, because we used to stay in a joint family. And I have a huge age gap. So I'm the youngest. My first cousin sister is, 14 years elder to me. So they used to purposely make me sleep. So after every 2 3 hours, my mother is making me sleep so these kids could play. So I was, I think, continuously sleeping because I never let them play. So that was the stage. Yeah, that was the stage where they used to come up and tell my mother, that please make her go off to sleep. Then my mother, like, how much do I make her sleep? Like, she can't non-stop just keep sleeping. So yeah, they used to all bully me. So that was the stage where I'm getting bullied, actually.
That's interesting. So, when we started working on Royal Heirlooms, we were researching a lot of people, who could be the right voices for us. There are kind of people we could kind of collaborate with. And the name that instantly came up was your name. We absolutely loved the way you were working with block printing and reviving the
Right.
whole craft. And we felt that, there could be nothing better than doing a line of products with you. That's why, we contacted you, we got in touch, and we are now collaborating. So, Royal Heirlooms by Puneet Gupta Crafted Fine Goods, as a line with Richard Rajalakshmi, is going to be some beautiful block prints that you see for your home, for bed linens. They're going to be pearls. So, Richard, would you like to elaborate a little more on this line, and what exactly
Yeah.
are we going to see?
So I am very, very grateful. I couldn't have been more thankful, and I really appreciate it. So gratifying, to be a part and to
Love that.
collaborate with you all. And my actually the collection, we really work and work with the collection, giving a room, the home linen, the line that I'm working with, giving a room a very contemporary touch. It's the artisans who have been working in this handloom print, as you can see in this picture. For them, this art and craft has been passed on since generations. It's in their family. It's a part of their own history. It's part of their own culture, their traditions. So it is something that, and not only handlock, I would say all the craft and the art in India, we are so rich with culture, so rich with tradition. And, every product then has a story to say. Every product that you do has a story. And it then becomes so close to you. It becomes so close to an individual who's buying it, because you say it with so much of, there's so much of emotions that you sell your product with. It's just not a product. There is hard work, there is history, there's culture, there is generations who've been doing this work. It has been passed on. For them, it means a lot. So, yes.
So also I feel that the product that we're offering under our brand is not just a product. I think it's a voice, it's an
Yeah.
experience. So I would like you to share a bit more about the process, how every product is made, what is the process of block printing on the fabric, like how it's done.
So we use the cotton and the malmal fabric, which is very, very soft. Malmal was used generation. It's the most, it was used by the royals, since I know, like, probably,
Of course,
generations
I
and
mean,
generations.
we're hearing it
Yeah.
from the horse's mouth, actually.
So it was, so Malmal has been, of course, a fabric which has been part of every royal family. And of course, cotton is something that, used to be used in Rajasthan because of the weather there, because it used to be such extreme weather, so hot in the desert that time.
And I
And then
think
also,
that also one thing I would like to bring to everyone's notice that Danta is actually, it's almost near the border of Rajasthan, if I'm not
yeah,
wrong.
yeah,
Right.
yes, we are
So
40
that's why you have a lot of
kilometers.
Rajasthani influence also in
Yes,
your.
yes. And it's 40 kilometers away from the Rajasthan border. We're surrounded by the Ravlis, so very much we have a lot of influence of Rajasthan,
It's
northern
almost
people.
like a melting pot of Gujarat and Rajasthan,
Yeah,
right?
it's actually like that. That is true. And so the artisans actually, I give them the, you know, they were first, I used to give them the design, but I now work with their design because now I'm just the face of the brand. I'm just the voice. It's their work, it's their design. And what they do is that, you know, they make the block, they carve it with these little needles that they have, and they keep, you know, hitting that chunk of wood and carve that entire design. And it takes time, it needs a lot of concentration in doing that. And then your colors, obviously, they, you know, and they, it depends how many colors do you want in that block. It's eight or the seven, five, but maximum what it can take is eight colors. And then you mix up, and you, if you have eight colors, then the different eight blocks are made of the same design, taking in that every color. So that orange that you can see in the picture is a different block, the red is a different block, the green, and then they all come
Also,
together and
these are all organic dyes, so they don't have literally chemicals in them. That is another beautiful part of the product that one could actually take from.
and plus these organic colors are also very, very you know, expensive, and you can't just, you know, waste them. You can't just like open them and okay, you know, you just got 1 meter of printing done and that's it. You can't do that. So these artisans also, you know, look for work where they can print meters and meters, because you know there's a lot of cost that also goes
Enrolled.
into,
Yes.
you know, it's a lot of cost that is involved, and they also have to see to their pocket. You just, you know, can't be wasting the money that they also save on too.
Absolutely.
So
Absolutely.
yes.
So that's wonderful. I think why I wanted Richard to talk about the process was that so that we could understand that the piece, the product that we could buy has a full story, and there's a full process that goes behind it.
Yeah, and it takes a lot of time. It
Time
actually
to
takes a lot of
make it.
time, yeah.
So essentially, Royal Heirloom by Richard Rajalakshmi is what this entire product line is to be called. And under this product line, we could you could look at some amazing stuff for kids, some amazing blankets, some amazing bed linen, some amazing throws, cushion covers. So it's a lot to do with your rooms. It's a lot to do with the home linen is what we'll be offering, and we'll soon be putting that on our Instagram and social media for you to have a look at it. It's going to be an Instagram exclusive only, and these designs are going to be exclusive designs for Puneet Gupta Crafted Fine Goods. So and these are one of a kind. So why not support this noble cause? Why not give work through by joining Puneet Gupta Crafted Fine Goods, by joining Royal Heirlooms, you can actually give sustainable livelihood to a lot of craftsmen over the period of time during this journey. And Richard has been really, really supportive and one of our first patrons to join hands. So I think it's a great journey that way. So Richard, tell me something. When you start, when you were working for this, so you got support from your parents, or how was it like? And
Huge support from my parents. I don't think I could have done anything without their support. Trust me, it's been a huge, huge support from my parents. It has been a huge support from my very, very close friends that I have. And I could have done this or reached if I didn't have the family support, and if I didn't have my support from the friends who are, you know, are in Jaipur. So yes, a huge support from my, especially from my father, because my father was someone who said that, you know, okay, do whatever you want to, it's okay.
As long as you're doing something positive, right, for the
Yeah,
society, I
and
think for the greater good
exactly.
is what it is.
Yeah, he never stopped me or my sister. You know, none of us were stopped in doing whatever we want to or we would like to do. It was never a no till the time, of course, it's a noble cause or it's something that, you know, it's right. So yeah, huge support from him. I don't know if I could have reached anywhere without his and my mother's support.
And how does it feel like, about this collaboration, about Royal Heirloom by Richard Rajalakshmi, this entire line of?
You know, I appreciate the whole concept, and it's so gratifying because you know, I'm just so happy that we could work together towards, you know, a cause. It's, you know, we both individually are at a platform which we both are privileged, you know. We,
yes,
we don't have to think about so many things.
Absolutely.
And if we have that, you know, if we have that platform where you and me both are privileged, you know, then why not work together and get things done? And see, and out here, let's be very practical. It's a win-win situation for, you know, everybody. We
yes.
have our, you know, we have our businesses and our brand, you know, getting the, you know, getting the light that it should, and the artisans are getting their due, and you know, the cause that I want to support is getting.
I think it's like a national movement anyway. We are working towards making India stand. Like, you know, the whole local for local movement, this is the right time wherein we stand for each other and we talk about causes and we talk about the wonderful stuff that our country has to offer. And I think it's amazing to
share that. That is also there, and also, you know, it was, we artisans were always there. You know, one plus point of this lockdown is that finally they have come out. You know, finally people are appreciating their work. Artisans were there since years. They never went away.
Yes,
absolutely.
You rightly
said
that.
We got so influenced with the Western world. I'm not saying that, you know, don't get influenced with the Western world. Not at all. We're all living in 2020. We're all modern. But we got so influenced with the Western world where I felt that our traditions, our history, you know, took a seat back. You know, we just didn't pay attention to what's really happening, you know, in our side of the country.
And I think there are a lot of products, like even us as designers, there are a lot of products we're contemporizing. So it might be a traditional old craft, but then the way it's presented, it's in a completely new mold and fashion.
Exactly. You know, I'm not saying it has to be that Purane Zamana type only look. Not at all. You know, you can have the most modern looking things and wear it, but let's just do it with our own artisans and workers. You know?
So I think we've had a lot of serious conversation. I'm going to do a little quick rapid fire with you. It is called this or that.
God.
So there will be two things you have to say, you know, choose one between the two. So I'm going to start. So 24 hours of work or 24 hours of sleep?
Oh God, this is so difficult. My family will laugh if I say 24 hours of work. 24 hours of sleep. They literally laugh at me.
Instagram or Facebook?
Instagram.
Okay. Netflix or Amazon Prime?
Oh God. Netflix.
Netflix or books?
Netflix.
Okay. What are you watching currently on Netflix?
I'm watching Dynasty. I'm loving it.
I'm watching that too.
I'm loving it. And I just love Fallon Carrington in it. You know, every time I watch it, I wish I'm just like her.
She is on the roll. Like, she's one character even I admire. I mean,
she's on the roll. And her sentences are so, you know, just so apt at times. It's amazing.
The whole tongue in cheese, and it's too cool. Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
So, family or friends?
So difficult. Family. Because friends become family by the end of the day. So family.
Yeah. Binge eating or binge watching?
Binge watching. I'm not a very big foodie.
Okay.
Yeah.
So now I'm gonna be asking questions and you just have to give one word answer to them. So what was the last thing you cooked?
Nothing.
Why?
I don't know how to cook very well, Pudin. So I'm the worst to go in the kitchen. And my cook, who is 27-year-old guy who's been here with us for the last 27 years, actually.
So your Maharaj might just get offended, the kitchen.
No, he gets very offended. You can't help. He goes like, see, they call me Baba because obviously from the Lucknow side, he's a UP person. He's saying, Baba, aap mat aao kitchen mein, aap kuch nahi aate. They literally tell me. So I can't go. So I very happily don't go also.
What was the last thing you Googled?
What the last thing that I?
Googled online. search for
Google
something.
on, okay, Google on, what did I Google last on? How to get sponsorship done on Insta for the Instagram page. Yes, I Googled that last night. How to sponsor the page.
Okay. And what is the first thing that you will do when the lockdown is lifted?
I'm going to go and meet this friend of mine, Sakshi, who stays in Bombay, because every day I talk to her and every time I only want to go meet her. So I'm going to run to go meet her. So that's the first thing I'm definitely going to do.
City life or farm life?
Farm life.
Why is that?
Farm life is because you know, it's more open, it's more, you have like so much of space to do what you want to. I get my own space. If I want to read, I want to work out, I have my own space. And also then I can just call my entire bunch of friends.
And I think there's a lot of
greenery
as well, so I think
yeah.
Maybe
yeah.
Connected to nature, that's one
yeah.
thing.
Yeah,
I think that was an amazing and a very honest round. Totally. I can't send anything right now, but definitely after the lockdown,
yeah.
I will thank you for this. So lovely having you on this, having this conversation with you. So guys,
thank
I was
you.
In conversation with Princess Richa Rajalakshmi of Danta. She was sweet enough to give us time to speak to her, talk everything you know, about her life, about her passion, about the craft, about the line that we're launching with her. So any last words of positivity before, you know, we close the session, since you're all
in love. My only few words of positivity would be to everyone out there is that, you know, the cause that I'm supporting, I would want, of course, all the support in that cause. And also the main thing that I would like everyone is to change their little mindset towards these special kids, because I want these special kids to challenge the stereotypes, you know, the stereotype thinking, and also work with them to overcome difficulties. So I just wish everybody luck, and I wish everybody once the lockdown is over gets back to their work and, you know, whatever they all have decided to do. So I just look forward in seeing everyone come out, basically.
Thank you so much for those kind words of inspiration. I think that's quite thought-provoking and great to have you on the show. Have a great
thank
evening.
You, thank you, Puneet. Thank you. Have a great evening. And I hope I see you soon. And be safe. And
yes.
Wishing you all
yes.
the best for this new journey and endeavor
thank
that you have started. And I
yes.
wish
you're a
you
part
know,
of it. You're one of the people.
I know I'm a part of it, but anything at any time you need any help with anybody, you know, you're all free to just let me know. So thank you
yes.
so much for
thank
you know making me a part of
thank
this.
Thank you. Guys, that was Princess Richa Rajalakshmi with us. I think one thing that we've learned after having this conversation with us, with her, is that we need to be more empathetic about things around us. We have to be, we need to understand that these simple things of life, watching television, listening to music, eating food, these simple things which we normally, you know, feel that, you know, it's not really important, but even these basic things are important, and we're privileged to have them. We're privileged to have a house that we live in. We're privileged to have food. We're privileged to have the basics of life with us, during these hard times. And one should definitely try and associate with NGO which they feel is important for a cause, and do something for the greater good. So I would like to appeal all of you to support Richa in this noble cause of hearing impaired children and NGOs who are working towards them and champion this cause. And for the next episode, we have another Royal Princess coming in chatting with you. Till then, stay home, stay safe.